Now we discuss about strain. What is strain here? Strain is nothing but it is the fractional change in the dimension. Change in the dimension means it is a change in the, it may be change in the length or it may be change in the volume, like that. Now strain can be calculated by the principle strain is equals to change in dimension by original dimension. Change in dimension by original dimension is called here fractional change in dimension. Previously we discussed about mainly two types of stress, normal stress and tangential stress. Normal stress is again of two types, longitudinal stress and volume stress, and next type of stress is tangential stress. Like this, similar to corresponding to three types of stress, again there are three types of strain here. The first one is longitudinal strain and second one is volume strain and third one is tangential or shearing strain. Like this, strain is of three types: longitudinal strain, volume strain, tangential or shearing strain. Let's see first of all about longitudinal strain. Longitudinal strain again is of two types, similar to the two types of longitudinal stress. What are those? Tensile stress and compressive stress. It is again of two types: tensile strain and second one is compressive strain. Tensile strain means when a wire is subjected to tensile stress, then there may be increase in the length of the wire, like this. This is the wire. This wire is being pulled in opposite directions with force F and F to stretch it so that its length may increase. Now suppose its initial length is L. Its final length is L plus delta L. Now, how do you find the tensile strain? Tensile strain is equals to change in length by original length. That is here, especially increase in length by original length. How much is the increase in length here? That is delta L by original length is capital L. Here, this is the tensile strain. Tensile strain is equal to increase in length delta L by original length capital L. Now, similarly, we define the compressive strain. Now, compressive strain is nothing but similar to tensile strain, we define like here, decrease in length by original length means when a wire experiences compressive stress, means on its ends we apply two forces F and F to compress it, then its length may decrease. Suppose its initial length is capital L. Its length is decreased to L minus delta L. Now we calculate compressive strain is equals to decrease in length delta L by original length capital L. In this way we find the compressive strain. Now longitudinal strain is nothing but especially it is a change in length by original length. Here we discuss two cases: length may increase and length may decrease. If length is increased, the corresponding strain is the tensile strain. If length is decreased, the corresponding strain is the compressive strain. Now tensile strain means it is the increase in length by original length. Compressive strain means it is the decrease in length by original length. Now we define here volume strain. Here volume strain is the change in volume by original volume. It is a fractional change in the volume. Previously we discussed that when a object is completely immersed in a liquid, then all over the surface it experiences pressure perpendicular to the surface, so its volume may decrease but shape remains same. Now this much is the decrease in volume. This decrease in volume is delta V. Its original volume is V. V is the original volume. Decrease in volume is delta V. Now volume strain is given by the formula minus delta V by V. What does this minus indicate here? This minus indicates that a decrease in volume due to the applied pressure by the liquid or fluid. So volume strain is equal to change in volume by original volume. Similarly, then we define a tangential or a shearing strain.